Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and behind the camera is my wife, Connie. Glad you guys could join us. I've been wanting to make a hot tent for quite a while. I had a big 12 by 14 heavy-duty canvas wall tent, but the thing was huge. I need something smaller, more portable. So, also, I've gotten quite a few requests recently to show how to make a teepee. So, I decided I'm going to make a teepee hot tent. So that's what we're going to do on this video. We're going to actually make one step by step. I'm going to show you how to do it and materials you'll need and whatnot. But before we get started, let's go through some drawings, diagrams, so I can show you how it goes together and also to tell you we're not going to use a traditional teepee size. And you'll see why in just a little bit. Okay, let's get started. Now this is a standard 8.5 by 11 sheet. That's standard here for the United States. And the size tarp we're going to use is a 12 by 16. Now the ratios aren't quite exact from this to the tarp, but it's pretty close. So let's get started. Okay, first of all, we want to take the ends and double it over, crease it right in the middle. The reason for that is we need to know right where the middle is. Okay, now I'm going to use what they call a compass to draw an arc here. Now if you haven't got a compass, you can use a string and anchor the string right here and just arc the string. So we're going to do that with the compass. We're not trying to be real accurate here. This just for quick demonstration purposes. Okay, now you cut this out on the line. And this is what you end up with. Now to put this together, you fold the flat. Bring the flat edges together like this, like that. There's your teepee, okay? Like this. That's the teepee. Okay, now let me show you the modified teepee. Now this is complements this design. The modified teepee design is complements of a friend of mine named Charlie. He's the one that developed this, and he came up with the idea, and we slept in it when we were out hunting this fall, and it worked really good. And I'll show you why. Now, to start it off, what we need to do is crease it just like we did in the other one, so we got the middle. Now, let's go to the other side and make a crease also right in the middle. Okay, and make our little pencil marks here so it's easy to see where the middle is. Okay, now instead of placing the center here and making our arc as in the standard teepee, we want to place the center here like we did and make sure our arc is at the correct radius. But instead of marking from here, we'll go out to, okay, I got to place this right in the exact spot. We'll go out here and just make a mark right in the center. Okay. Now, take a straight edge and find out where the center is by your two marks that you placed right here and cross your arc. Now, that is our new place that we are gonna, that's the new center of our arc. Let's draw it out. Okay, and then you cut that out on the line, same as the other one. Now you'll notice, before we cut it out, notice the amount of, we'll call it tarp, notice the amount of tarp that is used and how much is wasted on the modified design versus how much tarp is used and how much waste there is on the traditional design. All right, now to get a new perspective, first of all, okay, to finish this off, draw from the center of your arc to the end of your arc on both sides. Okay. And then you cut this all out. All right. Now, to show you another comparison, we'll use our models. Here is the traditional design. Here is the modified design. Granted, the modified design is a little bit shorter, okay? But it's a whole lot wider. Now let me show you a different perspective on the square footage versus the square footage of the traditional. Here we go. This is the slouder circle is the square footage of the modified. See, place it on there like that and place this one on here and draw around it. So you can see how much difference there is between the modified and the traditional. Now to get an idea on how much room there will be in the modified, I have made out this would be 3 feet by 7 feet to simulate a sleeping bag, pad, sleeping area for the average person. Place that in there. Place the other one in here. Okay, and now we've got a little stove. This is this pretty standard size stove for a hot tent. It's 12 inches by 24 inches. So that gives you an idea on how much room we've got here. All right, before we head outside to get started making it, this is the finished tent. This is what it's gonna look like when it's all bundled up. It's made from an inexpensive poly tarp like you can get at Walmart or Fred Meyer here in the United States, or many sporting goods or hardware stores. I'm sure I'm going to be asked how heavy this is. So it's 8 pounds. All right. Now, I wanted to make this very simple. I wanted to make this in such a way that anybody could make it with a minimum of tools, very minimum of tools. It requires no sewing. This is put together with Gorilla tape. I've made tents before with duct tape, and they held together quite well. So I used Gorilla tape this time, which is much stronger, better adhesive, thicker tape, more heavy duty. And you can use I used black Gorilla tape. Now if you live in a hot area, going to be using the tent where there's a lot of hot sunshine, you might want to use the white Gorilla tape so that the adhesive on the tape doesn't heat up and get too thin. Now, it required just about 150 feet of tape. So that'll give you some idea on how much tape you're going to need. Now, this will hold 3 people without a stove in it. And you might be able to get 3 people with a stove. It'd be real tight. But now, if you need a bigger or a smaller tarp teepee, the way we figured it up, okay, This was 8.5 inches by 11 inches. Well, we divided this. Our tarp is 12 by 16, and the 16 feet is the full width of the tarp. The teepee is the full width of the tarp when it's made, when it's cut out. So 8.5 inches divided by 16 feet gave me an idea on how big this was going to be before we made it. Okay, so if you need a bigger tarp, you're going to use the same size paper to design it, but say you're going to use a 20 foot wide tarp, you'll need to divide that into 20 segments. Each one of those segments would then be a foot. So then you can use that distance between each of those segments to measure, say the 3 feet by 7 feet that I allotted for each sleeping person. So that'll give you an idea on how big of a tarp you're going to need to buy. Now, for some reason, you can't find the right sized tarp pre-made. Well, that's no real big deal. You can always, believe it or not, tape two tarps together using the Gorilla tape, and then cut your teepee pattern out of that. All right, let's go outside and start putting it together. Come on. All right, what we did was we staked this out, all four corners, and put in a few stakes on the sides here too, till we ran out of stakes. Okay, and we measured. Okay, this is lengthwise here. This is the long way. We measured from one side to the other, cut it exactly in half, and put a stake right there in the half. We did the same on the back side, measured the length and put a stake right in the middle. Okay, now we take a rope, tie a loop on the end, and we go up here and measure to the edge. Then we go up here, measure, and this will be the top. This would be the top of the traditional teepee arc. Okay, so this is where the center of the modified teepee arc will be. We tied the rope, stretched out the rope from that center to this center to know where to place this this spike. Okay, once we determine the top of the arc, traditional teepee arc, and the center, we put a spike in there. Okay, now we remove the loop. And we put it on the spike here, our new center. Okay, now, it's important to stake this down all the way around as best you can, especially if you're like me. This situation here where we're on snow and we're on a little bit of a slope, because the tarp wants to shift around. And when that happens, you can really mess up your measurements. So be sure and stake it out real good. Okay, now we are ready to start cutting it out. This should reach to the top, and it does. And it should reach to the side,
and it does.
That's a little verification. All right, now what I've done is I've tied my knife on here, tied it secure so it's not going to slip. Now to verify, you want to make sure you hold the knife vertical. Go along here, check on this side. That looks good. Check at the top. That looks real close. And check on this side, and that looks good. All right, we're ready to start cutting. So we're gonna start from right here. Make sure that is down at the bottom. And we're gonna start cutting. And like I said before, you wanna make sure you keep your knife vertical. And do the same all the way around the arc. All right, we got that much done. Let's go ahead and pull back the pull back the excess so we can kind of see what we got here. So there's the rough outline. All right, now what we've done is we've taken a rope from the center of our arc, and the end of our arc where it joined the edge over here, the original edge, we drove a spike through that. Now this rope is going to be our reference point for cutting this out. Now let me say at this point that I'm kind of a handicap here because we don't have a large enough indoor area to do this in, but if you have a large indoor floor that you can lay this on and tape it, of course, instead of spiking it, and use a permanent pin and mark it all out with a pin before you cut on a flat floor, it'll go a lot better than this. But this is the way we have to do it. All right, now we go to the other side. There's our teepee, rough cutout. Now what we need to do is go inside and work on the rest of it in the house. So, tape it right along the edge and then string it out My wife has volunteered to be my lovely assistant, and we found that's the way this works best, is to have two people work on this. Okay, she will spread out and keep tension on the tarp while I place the tape. Okay, on the curved sections where I'm going around the radius of the teepee, I have to constantly be pulling, keeping a tension on the tape, pulling it around the radius as I place it down as I go. This particular section is just a straight section along the door. So this is all we do. Just like that. Okay, now, after you have the tape on both sides of the tarp, some of your tarp, where you didn't cut so even, perhaps, if you're doing it more freehand like I am, I go along and then trim off this extra bit of tarp. Maybe this blue will show up better. I go along with scissors and trim off this extra bit of tarp down to the tape, just to dress it up. Now we put grommets in all the way around, and I'll show you how that was done. I put them every 3 feet. Okay, it may not need to be every 3 feet, maybe every 4 feet would be sufficient. I won't really know that until I set it up. Okay, now I did that starting from one edge, working clear around the arc to the other edge. Okay, now this last one before the last edge here isn't going to be quite 3 feet, because over here is the edge and it won't be quite 3 feet either. So what I did was I split the difference. So we'll put it right here, and I'll show you how that's done. Now, for the grommet. These grommet kits can be purchased. Here's another kit. They can be purchased at most department sporting goods stores like Walmart, or I'm sure you can find them online. This is 3/8 sized grommets. Now you use your hole cutter that's provided with the grommet kit, and you punch a hole through. We're going to put it right in the middle of the tape. I like to twist it and push it a little bit. That way I know whether or not it's got it cut all the way around the circle. Okay, pull that out, and you need to pop out the piece that you just cut. Otherwise, after you get a few pieces cut in this, it's a tube, and it makes it harder to cut the next one. So I just pop out each one after I cut it. Now let's put the grommet in. Okay, you want to use this piece down first, and this here piece that comes also with the grommet kit is shaped to cup the grommet in just cradle it just fine so it doesn't get deformed during the placing of the grommet. Then you place the washer part of the grommet over it with the cup shaping up. And then this is the another tool that comes with the kit. You slip that over here and hold it down low so that you're sure that it's you don't want to hammer on it at an angle. Make sure it's straight up and down. So I like to do it until I can feel a good solid fit. And there's the grommet, the finished grommet. All right, let's go on to the next part. All right, before we set it up, I want to explain exactly how I put it together. Okay, I went clear around the radius of the whole thing with the black Gorilla tape, both on the outside and on the inside. I put the grommets every 3 feet, the brass grommets, brass coated steel grommets. Okay. Now, I didn't plan on staking through the grommets. And the reason why was I wanted a stake area large enough that I could make stakes out in the field if I needed to. So, I tied some paracord onto each grommet. All right, so I put black tape around the radius. And I put black tape up both sides of the doorway, same as I did around the radius. All right, now let's put it together, start setting it up. Now to do that, it's very simple to set up. You'll want your door together. So we'll do that first. Now it's springtime here in South Central Alaska. And the daytime temperatures are 40, in the 40s, so the snow isn't real cooperative right now. It's not binding up. So I hope this works. Okay, you put the door together and you more or less lay it all out to where it's in a circle, which it pretty much naturally wants to do. All right, that looks good. Let's go ahead and stake it up. It's very simple to set up, actually. Got it staked all the way around. Let's go ahead and pitch the tent. Thank you. there it is. Now, once you have it pitched, you go around and see if there any of these need to be tightened up. This one appears to be a little bit loose, so reposition, you know, all the way around. All right, let's take a walk around it. We're at a neighbor's cabin here, so that's what you see. Back to the door. Now, before we go inside, I want to explain something. Here is the original door, and what I did with some of the scrap tarp, I cut out an extra wedge and taped it on. See? And I taped it across the top as well. The reason being is it makes it waterproof, so that, well, let me show you. I will unhook the door. Okay. The original door just butted to itself, so rain could come in and right through the door. Well, now it's arranged to where it's waterproof. The rain will come down and land on this and flow both ways because of the arc of the teepee and flow on down. Okay, I want to show a little detail here of how I reinforced the top. Okay, you can see perhaps a little better how I put this extra flap on that goes over the door to waterproof the door, and I put extra layers of Gorilla tape over the top. Okay, let's go inside, and okay, you can see how I put extra layers of Gorilla tape on the inside as well, to reinforce the top to handle the stick. Okay, speaking of the stick, say you don't want to use the stick. You want room in here perhaps for three people. Well, what you could do is you could use a tarp clip. Okay, there's many different varieties of these tarp clips out now. And one thing you want to look for when looking for the tarp clips, you want to make sure that the jaws will go wide enough to be able to grip the thickness of that reinforced top peak of the teepee, and that it'll supply a grip strong enough to be able to grip it and not slip. Okay, so once you grip the top of the teepee with your tarp clip, then you just hang it from a bipod. Okay, the bipod will be a stick coming up this side and a stick coming up this side from the ground, overlapping each other, lash them together, and then hang your teepee from that bipod. And you adjust the legs of the bipod to where you want them so that they are centered over the top of the teepee and the teepee walls are tensioned the way you want them. All right. There's the interior. All right, plenty of room for two people to lay down. You want to go ahead and lay down there, sweetheart? Okay, so you can see there's plenty of room in there for up to three people without the stove. Okay, let me show you the stove I had in mind for the teepee. All right, this is the stove that I had planned on using. It's an old military stove that called it was commonly called a Yukon stove. All right, that's, quite useful stove. Unfortunately, the thing is rather huge and takes up a lot of area in the teepee, and it's going to be way more stove than I need. Okay, there's 24-inch firebox here, plus this here added on. So I don't know, it's about 33 inches or so, and it's just more stove than I need. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a stove. I haven't put in the stove jack in the teepee yet, you may have noticed. So that'll be in a future video where I put in the stove jack, show you how I do that and what it's made out of. And I'm going to make a stove, and hopefully we'll see how I made that. All right, in the meantime, I'll put this in the teepee and maybe give you a better idea on a better perspective on the room in the teepee. All right, we got the stove in here, pretty much where it would go, more or less. And here's how a person would be laying in here, more or less. So that's what it looks like. All right. Thanks for joining me, and you guys take care, and we'll see you on the next video.